Hello, once again, Alphabets, and we are right back to it. Welcome back to Let's Play East Origin. I am, as usual, your host, HKHD. When we last left off, we were fighting this butthole. And not doing the best. I was starting to get his, there we go. I've gotten his telegraphs down, so I know how he plays. And, I'm just trying very hard not to, die again. Lasers. These lasers suck. These lasers can go die in a fire. But they're not the hardest thing to dodge. Thank you for falling. Ow. Something you also might have remembered in the last one is I died because at one point because the cat decided he wanted to hop up on my table. Right in front of my screen, so I couldn't see what I was doing. Oh, it ended early. It ended early. You're not allowed to end early. It's not cool, man. That stage is not meant to end early. Come on. You are one ugly guy, you know that? I mean, yeah, you kind of have a baby face, but those teeth. Those teeth. I'm getting better at dodging these lasers, though. Well, I say as I get hit. Alright, what stage are you going to be going this time? Because, yeah, you know what? I'm actually okay with this. This version of you is much easier to deal with than when you're at half health. Maybe I can get you down past half health before you go into your next stage. Maybe. Who knows? Okay, lasers. Lasers. Me no likey the laser. It's okay, though. Like I said, I know how to dodge you now. Of course, I miss. There we go. Yes, I can get you down past half health like that. Awesome. Doesn't matter. You are now in stage two. Good thing I was in boost mode. Half damage. That's the other thing. I'm thinking to myself, like, using the Thunder Crash works great when I can be up nice and close to him, but I can't be up all nice and close to him. I just can't. At least I can't guarantee that I'll be up nice and close to him. And there I go. I'm getting there. I'll probably have to do like I do with Valgarmanda. Whatever the thing was. The thing with the giant mouth. And, just cut out a lot of footage in between the deaths and such. Because I'm not really able to focus on saying anything intelligible at this point. All I'm trying to do is not die. And doing a piss poor job of it, too, if I might say. Suppose I could, if I really wanted to, try to go back and do more leveling, but it would take for so long to get the next levels. Next punch. Next punch. Thank you very much for being accommodating and actually punching me the way I wanted you to. And here I was going to mention how much better I've been getting at dodging out of the way of his punches. Past half health. I am still above half health. No, I'm not. This is not looking good for me. See what I can be sure I can get. Oh. When I'm sure I can get in close, Thunder Crash. Punch me beneath the Billy Barley. Alright, didn't get hit by the smash. That's good. That means I can do this. I got you under my skin. Lasers. Lasers are not a problem. Lasers are not a problem for me. Can't you see? The lasers really don't do much damage, and I'm getting better at dodging them. So, your lasers really don't mean that much to me. Okay. Stage two of the fight. Come on. Fight me. I don't think I have it in me. Yes, I do. I have it in me. I am greater than you, construct. I am greater than you. I stand alone against a beast that's in front of me, made of machines and fire. Ow. Come on. Got 6 hit points left. One hand down. And lava. Phew. I'm getting there, though. I am getting there. Oh. Ow. 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 I had to stop to scratch. You can't pause this. I don't know if I mentioned that. I can't pause this game. I can't go into my menu. There's no way to pause. And there's no way to heal. So I have to try really hard to not get hurt. I can do this if I focus. I don't know. Stop with the fucking lasers. They're just annoying. You know, everything about you is annoying now. Lava and lasers and those little fire things, which don't do me anything. Yeah, maybe if they gave me health or something, but no. Just go ahead and die. Just do it. Just retry it. Okay. Don't get frustrated. Don't get frustrated. There once was a man from the nation of Albonia. Albonia was a fun and happy place because people there were lively and gay, and they had parties all the time, and they never had to deal with fighting giant robotic fire monsters. They never had to deal with that because those such things didn't exist in Albonia. The only thing they had to deal with was parties. They were kind of like hobbits. All they did every day was party and eat and have fun. What kinds of fun? Well, all sorts of fun, if you're asking me. The sorts of fun that are had where you play party games. Yes, lots of party games. And there were some adult-themed games. I mean, the place is called Albonia, with an A, not an I, but still. And in Albonia, like I said, no giant monsters to fight, no fire aside for to cook, no lasers, nothing like that. All you do is you spend all your day having fun and partying. There's no money. There's no need for money, no need for leveling up or experience, no need to buy better equipment for yourself, unless you're talking about party equipment, in which case, you know, everyone can use party equipment. It's what makes parties parties. Party equipment. And that has nothing to do with the kind of parties where it's a group of people to fight monsters. Because as I said, there are no monsters in Albonia. There are no monsters at all. And the people in Albonia are like elves, but people. They are very peaceful and magical. And they just like having relaxing times. Enjoying themselves, not worrying about giant evil monsters. Because, as I said, giant evil monsters don't exist there. There's no stress. No stress and nothing to really work a guy into any sort of anger or resentment towards people who built giant robots and monsters, because those don't exist. And lava. Lava. Lava may exist, but the people don't go anywhere near it. They don't build near volcanoes. They don't go down deep into mines. Minecraft doesn't exist in Albonia, because that would mean that they would have the chance of accidentally falling into lava. And nobody likes doing that. Nobody likes going into lava and losing all your stuff. So, in Albonia, there was this prince. It was a woman, wasn't it? It was a lady, a princess from Albonia, who was supposed to marry the prince of another nation, a nation called Rockford. Yes, Rockford. Albonia and Rockford had close ties, and the princess of Albonia was supposed to marry the prince of Rockford. So this is a story about a young man in the future who gets the chance to be able to do everything he ever wants to do. His mother is a doctor, he lives in a futuristic society where you can get everything you ever wanted for free. And it's very nice, very peaceful, and people don't have to worry about fighting giant monsters in this place. And instead, you spend your time on a giant room that is able to project all the wonderful things you might want in your life. You could pretend that you're a great artist or chef, and ply your wares to the people of a town. You can be a hero if you want, but who wants to do that? Who wants to act like a hero fighting giant monsters? Not me, I say. You can meet a person with white skin who is whistling. If you really want to, you can go and snowballs. You can throw snowballs at other people. But this individual had everything he could ever want because of this machine, but decided instead he wanted to pilot a great starship and not spend all of his time in the place where you can have everything you ever wanted, which was funny because as a teenager, you would think he would spend a lot of time using certain programs in this thing. But instead, no, he wanted to be an officer of a certain intergalactic organization. And I'm sure you may have decided for yourself who it is that I am referring to. You may or may not be right. You probably are, actually. And if the person who I'm talking about, at least an individual related to the person that I'm talking about, were to somehow find this, I'm literally just talking about this just to keep my mind off of how aggravated I am getting at fighting this boss. So I am sorry for telling the stories of you and your... though I didn't really tell much of a story yet. He's going to go off and train to be an awesome person at a intergalactic thing, and unfortunately had some problems doing so because things went bad for him. And then he came back and he met some people who were Native Americans in space, and along with them he learns that sometimes you need to find your own path and not follow the path of your parents. And that's the way that you do things. Because if you follow your own path, then you will be happy. But if you follow the path that you think your parents want you to follow, then you can end up miserable and not enjoying life. But he didn't want to do that. He wanted to do what he wanted to do. So he went off with a guy... and basically became a interdimensional intergalactic traveler for a while and did not get eaten, but I did. So this is a story about a young man who so much of this is going to get cut out. It's not funny because I am getting so close to actually beating this guy. I say that, and you guys are like, yeah, sure, why don't you just show us how close you are? And I'd love to show you how close I am. but it's taking a while. Lasers. All I want to do right now is tell stories to... I'm trying to fill up silence, basically, because this is a Let's Play. You're here to see me slowly go insane, which is what I have been doing in this fight. Slowly going insane. Okay, so this next story involves a young man who lives on... It's also a world in space, a space sort of thing, futuristic science fiction sort of deal. This young man wants, for nothing else, but to go off and leave his crummy life. See, he lives as a farmer, and all he wants is to leave the crummy life of a farmer and go out into the stars and make a name for himself. But he can't, because he has it's a family farm, and the family needs him. So his family is like, you can't leave, we're sorry, but we need you here. And so they hire on a couple of helpers to help around the farm. But they still need him, even though they've hired these helpers on. One of the helpers decides to run away, because he decides he's actually the helper of another individual. And so this leaves the young man feeling rather disturbed, because he's never seen a helper like this just go off and leave. So he goes off on his own. Well, not on his own. He takes the other helper with him, and they go off and they try and find the helper that left. And in doing so... they come across a bunch, a gang of creatures who try to shoot him. And he shoots them first. Well, not really. I'm giving you bad information here. They find the helper that left. These creatures knock him out, knock out the guy, and knock out... the other helper too, but the one that left kind of hides, and then somebody approaches and scares away the creatures that knocked out the young man, and in doing so helps him stand up, and he's like, hey, so I scared those guys away, we need to get out of here, so let's do it. So they leave, and he's like, here, I knew your dad, and he gave you, he had this really cool, like, laser sword, and he wanted you to have it when you were old enough, but your rest of your family didn't want you to have it, so here, have it, it's yours. And so the young man takes this awesome laser sword and he turns it on, because it's... I was doing so good that time too. See, there's some strategy going on now. So he doesn't shift into the second stage of the fight until he's past half health. So, if I can keep him from going into the second stage of the fight as long as possible. See, this part's simple to dodge. This is the easy part to deal with. It's when he starts, when cells fall away, that things start getting a little more difficult for me. As it stands now, this I can deal with. Oh, so close. Yep, I've lost this. Yep. And I'm back. I'm not counting that death. I had a phone call, and I can't pause. Geldi! Your name is Geldi? Really? I'm just now noticing that. Your name is Geldi. Entire episode just on this boss. And I can't get close to beating him. Well, I can get close. I just can't. Ugh. That was entirely my fault there. All right, I gotta take a break from this. I'll do what I can for the next episode to make sure that I'm ready to fight this boss again and actually beat him. Maybe if I have to spend some time, grinding, I'll do what I have to do. So that was just getting really frustrating. Thank you very much for watching. This has been, Let's Play East Origins Yunica Story. I am your, host, HKHD. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and may the Force be with you.